Tervetuloa, minä olen Jeffre. Ja pelataan 9 hours, 9 persons, 9 doors. Eli 9, 9, 9. Eli, tää peli on sinänsä jännä, kun mitä mä olen ymmärtänyt, niin tää on tällainen... Tää on tällainen visual novelin tyylinen ja... Sen, niin tässä on niin ihan oma tämmönen tarinasysteemi ja tässä on niinku, siis tää on joku sun ihan mä en, tää on omasta mielestä aika mindfuck peli oikeastaan. Ja tällä videolla minä osallistun Rampen Video Challenge Övertarget, mien oli miten se kutsutaan, lausutaankaan kun se Rampe, miksi laitat sellaisia outoja nimiä niille? Boom, motherfucker. No niin, siellä meidän laiva onkin. A large noise startled Junpei awake, and his eyes snapped open. As they adjusted to the light, he realized that he didn't recognize his surroundings. Ow! With a crack, Junpei's head connected with something metal. He rolled over and threw out his hand to steady himself, but he found himself groping at empty air. His balance lost, and his still fuzzy mind struggling to understand what was going on, Junpei tumbled down to the cold gray floor. Ouch, goddammit! Gah, what the hell? Junpei glared around the room, still trying to determine where he'd woken up. The fall had shaken the last cobwebs of sleep from his mind, and finally he understood where he'd fallen from. It was a bed. A three-level bunk bed, in fact. Junpei had fallen, apparently, from the topmost bunk. His shoulder hurt, his knee hurt, his hip hurt, his entire body hurt. He could feel a bump forming on his forehead where he'd slammed it against the low ceiling. He wondered if that bump was the reason he felt his vision wavering a bit, but that seemed unlikely. At first, he thought the tremor that ran through his legs was just another effect of his rude awakening, but as he looked around, he realized it was real. The whole room was shaking. Was it an earthquake, he wondered? It didn't seem likely. It was shaking far too quickly for an earthquake. Then again, Junpei had no idea what it was, if not an earthquake. He tried to tell himself it was important. Junpei rubbed the growing bump on his head and gingerly climbed to his feet. His balance regained, he finally took his first good look around the room. And muttered to himself, Where am I? His pain momentarily forgotten the face of the confusion of his circumstances, Junpei looked around the room once again. Minutes passed while Junpei struggled to get his bearings. Then, as suddenly as they had begun, the tremor ceased. A cold silence fell over the room. From somewhere far away, Junpei could hear the sound of metal squeaking. He felt his stomach tighten. There were a thousand things the sound could have been, but none of the things he could think of were good. In an attempt To distract himself, Junpei looked around the room once more. There was a stove that looked more antique than functional. The three-level bunk bed had mattresses on that were so thin that they were little more than blankets. On the other side of the room was an identical bed, and set in the wall between the beds was a slightly dirty iron door. The first thing Junpei noticed about the door was the number roughly emblazoned across it. On the surface of the door, in red paint, someone had written 5. 5? What's this 5 mean? Suspicious and still utterly confused, Junpei approached the door slowly. Standing at last in front of the door, Junpei grabbed hold of the L-shaped handle. A pause yielded no movement, and a pull the same result. A few more tries cemented the truth in Junpei's mind. It wouldn't open. It didn't matter how much he pushed and shoved, the handle wouldn't budge. The next to the door was an odd-looking device that reminded Junpei of a card reader. It didn't take a genius to figure out that the odd-looking device was keeping the door shut. Junpei knocked hard on the door. Hey! Hello! Is anyone there? Open the door! There was no response. Junpei threw his left fist into the door. I stopped. What the hell is this? He wasn't really sure what else to say. On his left wrist was a bracelet of a sort he'd never seen before. In the center was a large LCD display. On his left wrist was a bracelet of a sort he'd never seen before. In the center was a large LCD display. It looked like nothing else so much as a watch, but it clearly wasn't that. After all, it showed only a single number. 5. That's the same as the door. True, the numbers were the same, but he had no idea what that might mean. All he knew that it was strange and new, and he wanted it off. Junpei flipped his hand over as if to remove a watch, but wah wah wah. On the other side of the bracelet was solid, no buckle, no clasp, nothing. He sighed and flipped the thing back over. There were a number of rivets around the rim of the face, perhaps. He pushed them, but nothing happened. On a watch, there might be dials for adjusting date or time, but on this bracelet, they did nothing. Junpei was at a loss. What was he going to do? Growing more desperate, he began to tug at it. However, it's no good. Damn thing won't come off. A steel ring rang from the face, around Junpei's wrist, and back into the face. He wouldn't be pulling the bracelet off any time in the near future. What the hell is the deal with this thing? Frustration and inspiration were beginning to mix as the reality of the situation began to dawn fully on Junpei. So much was happening and none of it made sense. Junpei felt as though he were about to explode. Where am I? And why the hell am I here? Why? What the hell happened to me? Whoa. It was at that moment that he noticed the window. The window was round-rimmed in riveted brass like a window from an early 20th century ship. What? Wait, Am I in a ship? Jumbo walked slowly toward the window. He could see nothing beyond it but thick, impenetrable darkness. Jumbo squinted, trying to see something, anything. It was at that moment. Uh-oh. What the? You gotta be kidding me. What the hell is going on here? A crack split the glass of the window, and for a moment Junpei stared at it. Then the window burst and water began to pour into the room.
What the hell? God damn it!
Junpei yelled and spun around. His feet slipping on the water already coming through the window, he ran over the door. Hey! Anyone? Is anyone there? Come on, if you're there, say something. There was no reply. As Junpei screamed and pounded on the door, the water began to rise. It was now ankle deep on the floor and rising quickly towards his knees. Things were not looking good for Junpei. Not good at all. He needed to find a way out, and quickly. Junpei ran a hand across his forehead, brushing the sweat out of his eyes, and looked around the room. Noni! Seek a way out. Eli nyt sitten päästään katsomaan tätä meidän paikkaa, että minkälainen tää on tämä meidän... Tämä meidän... peli. Operations during an escape. During an escape, you can move to different parts of the room by touching the bottom screen. Eli bottom screen, mennään tätä. Since many areas require very exact selection, we recommend you use the stylus. Searching during an escape. During an escape, you can touch the background to search anywhere in the room.
Areas you can investigate will be highlighted yellow the moment you touch them.
Depending on the nature of the location you touch, you might find an item or a hint. Begin searching by touching places on the bottom screen. How to move? That's the triangle icon on the bottom screen. Doing so will change the viewing angle of the room, and you move to different locations. You can do the same thing by pressing left, right and down on the control pad. Eli mä voisin tältä näppäimistä vaikka painaa vasemmalle oikealle alas, jos mä haluaisin. Bird's eye view. If you want to know where you are, touch the X on the camera icon on the bottom screen. This will show you where you are and what direction you're facing. Saving during an escape. Pressing start will allow you to save. If you want to quit, we recommend pressing start. Purpose of the escape. The purpose of each escape is to get out of the room. How you do that depends on the room. You'll need to search all throughout the room to discover what you'll need to do to get out. Search for hints and items that may help you find a way out. Eli tosiaan, näin. Tuolla on jotain. Mikäs tämä on? Se on jumittunut laukku. Siinä on joku tommonen koodisysteemi. Eli tähän mä pitää laittaa avain sitten myöhemmin. Mutta katsellaan ympärille vielä hetken, niin avataan tämä näin. Mitäs vittua, täältä löytyy tämmönen samanlainen laukku, mutta se on vaan punainen. Hetkonen, eikös tuolla oli jotain? No niin, täällä jotain. Tuossa on jotain. No niin. Ja me löytin täältä muutama item, joita me pitää ottaa kuitenkin tähän. Käyttöön tässä pelissä loppujen lopuksi. Niin, eli me saatiin tämmönen taulu. Jossa näköjään joku tuo laiva, olisiko tuossa edessä joku tuosta laivasta, etuosa tuosta laivasta. Joo, joo. Okei. Otetaan näitä paperilappujakin täältä. Oi harmi, ei löytynyt mitään. No niin, ja me täällä yritetään katsoa, että onko mahdollista niinkö vaikka niinkö pysäyttää tuon veden tullut vaikka tunkemalla lakanoita sinne paikkaan, missä se on se reikä. No, sieltä tulee vähän liikaa vettä, niin ei oikein pysty. Mitäs vittua täällä? Oho! Punainen avain. Junpei grabbed the key and shoved it into his pocket. He intended to leave immediately, but something stopped him. His reflection started staring back at him from the mirror, but he had scarcely recognized himself. What's up with my face? His confusion was well justified. His face was drawn and pale, and the dark circles under his eyes made him look as though he was nearly dead. Man, what the hell happened to me? How did I end up here? Even as he said it, something in his mind opened and a memory popped to the surface. It was the last thing Junpei remembered before waking up in the strange room. It was past midnight when he came home. Junpei shuffled up the stairs and opened the door to apartment 201. Inside was his apartment, a small one-bedroom affair that ran him about $630 a month. He moved into it when he entered college, and so far he'd been there for 3 years and 7 months. He stepped inside and turned on the lights. The fluorescent light on the ceiling blinked and flickered slowly to life, as if waking blah 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 yo. The air cold light illuminated landscape he'd come home to so many times before. Everything was as he'd left it. The magazines piled up in the corner, the textbooks collecting dust, the CD cases covering the floor, the jeans and t-shirt he'd worn the day before then tossed onto the floor. There was one thing that didn't belong, however. There was a breeze. Breaths of cold night air wafted into his apartment, carrying the smells of autumn with them. The white curtain framing his window swayed gently in the wind. Ah, that's weird. Did I leave it open?
Junpei walked toward the window,
trying to remember if he'd closed it or not before he left. One of the panes was hanging open. He stuck his head out and looked around. Nothing seemed out of the ordinary. Junpei shrugged. He must have just left it open earlier. He closed the window. Then it happened.
Crossed.
Junpei turned and found himself face to mask with a man dressed all in black. The man wore a deep hood and a bulky gas mask. His face was entirely hidden. Junpei tried to scream, but all he could manage was a strangled croak. He tried to step toward the man, but his legs could no longer support his weight. Junpei collapsed to the floor, a crumpled heap of limbs, like a discarded puppet. Kaasugranaatti. Too late, he noticed that the white smoke was quickly filling his apartment. A small object shaped distressingly like a grenade set on the floor in front of his face, hissing. The wet smoke poured out of it at an incredible rate. The smoke had grown so thick that the details of Junpei's apartment began to fade into the wet haze. He could feel his mind begin to fade as well, a white haze that was not the smoke creeping into the edges of his vision. Consider this a privilege. You have been chosen. A rasping voice wormed its way out of the gas mask. It was cold and harsh and distorted in some way Junpei couldn't put his finger on. You are going to participate in a game. The nonary game. It is a game where you will put your life on the line. That was the last thing Junpei remembered. The white smoke overpowered him. The masked man faded from his vision and he felt his consciousness fall away into the white mist. That's right. That guy with the gas mask. That son of a bitch must have taken me here. As to who the man was or might have been, Junpei had no idea. Indeed, he wasn't even sure that his assailant had been a man. The voice had been cold and mechanical, like they passed through a voice changer, and the body had been covered with a thick cloak. Who was the man in the mask? You have been chosen. Junpei remembered that much, but what it might mean, that was beyond him. Junpei had no idea where he was or why he was there. There was only one thing from his memory that seemed important. You are going to participate in a game. The nonary game. It is a game where you will put your life on the line. The nonary game, huh? What the hell is a nonary game? Good. With a yell, Junpei drove his fist into the mirror. Mutta joo, eiköhän me kuule tähän lopetella tämänkertainen 999 jaksomme. Tästä tulee yllättävän pitkä tästä kästä jaksosta. Mutta heittäkääpä veikkauksia, mitä meillä tulee sitten ensi kerralla tapahtumaan. Nimittäin mä ajattelin tästä pelasta tätä tällaisen, että tää katsoo, että saisi veikkailla, mitä täällä tapahtuu, ja mä tuun tekemään sen tän videosarjan kommentoinnin sillä lailla, että mä laitan aina, että minun pitää katsoa ensin kommentit läpi, ennen kuin ne menee läpi tuolta kommenttiluota. Mutta mä olin Jeffre, ja me nähdään taas joskus. Ja muistakaa kommentoi ja tykätä, tilata ja niin edespäin ja jees. Eikä siinä. Meikäläisen osalta morjentees.